I want to specially welcome you again to Inspired Moments today. I'm so glad to have you on my video. I'm so glad you took time to click on the video and to watch. Today, I trust God that your life will be transformed again. And I want to share with you from my daily devotional, Inspiration Devotional. By the grace of God, this devotion has been in circulation for about 11 years now. And I trust God that this will be a blessing to you. My emphasis today is on imagination trap. Imagination trap. We'll take our text from 2 Corinthians chapter 10 and verse 5. Casting down imagination and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ. The human mind is one of the greatest assets, the greatest tools that God has given us to use in life. It's a major endowment. It's a major tool that God has given you to make the best of your life as an individual. One basic function of the mind is imagination. One basic function of the mind is imagination. Imagination is the ability to form images from imagination. Imagination is the ability to form images in our minds. With this, we can preview the past or preplay the future. Let me say that again. The mind is as a function of helping us to create images in our minds. And with that image, we can actually preview the past or preplay the future. Imagination can be a blessing or a trap, depending on how we use our imagination. The truth is this: imagination is something that is continually going on in your life. I'm sure you have seen cases where someone, you are talking to somebody and the person is not with you. You are talking to somebody and they can't even hear what you say, but because they are lost in thoughts. That was a process, or I'm sure an imagination was going on inside them. And so imagination can be a blessing, and of course it can be a trap, depending on how we use it. That's how we refer to as imagination trap. And you know, to follow me closely as we go on. The imagination is fed and set into motion by pictures that we expose ourselves to, or audible information. The pictures you see with your eyes, the things you hear with your ears, your eyes and your ears are the gateways to your mind, and they feed your imagination. And so the picture from your environment, the audible information from your environment gains entrance into your mind, and those become the raw materials for your imagination. It's important that we understand this. Whenever we see something, the image of what you have seen is immediately transferred into your mind. Every time you see something, the picture, the image is immediately transferred into your mind. And that is why when you have a dream in the night, okay, maybe a bad dream, something terrible that you saw, it can become an imagination from you, because that picture is transferred into your mind. The mind will now begin to process that information, either through pictures or through an audible information. Your mind will begin to process the information. And the longer the image is allowed to stay on our minds, or the audible information, the more it creates a reality in our minds, which will eventually become a reality in our outward experience. As soon as you receive the picture, as soon as you hear the audible information, whatever it may be, okay, it can be the report of a doctor, it could be a terrible news from somewhere, it could be somebody abuse on your life, it could be somebody's, you know, misrepresenting you. Once you receive that information, your mind will begin to process that information. And the longer it stays in your mind, it will eventually create a reality in your mind. And once that reality is created in your mind, it eventually become an outward experience in your life also. Now, the imagination becomes a trap. Don't forget we're talking about imagination trap. The imagination becomes a trap when negative and wrong information is allowed to germinate, to grow, and to develop in our minds. Listen carefully. Imagination becomes a trap when the wrong and the negative information you receive is allowed to germinate, is allowed to grow and develop in our minds. Yes, you can't prevent flies from flying over your head, but you can stop them from staying over your head. And so it's true that from time to time, you will see things, you will hear things, but you have a choice to make to either allow them to stay or to get rid of them immediately. And so once those negative and wrong information comes, once you allow them to stay, they'll begin to germinate. They will take roots downwards. They will germinate. They will grow and develop realities in your mind as an individual. Someone had a dream of an accident and then began to think about it. And then after thinking about it, without even knowing, you begin to talk about it. That's the process. It enters your mind. You saw the picture, okay? And now you begin to think about it. And once it gets roots in your heart, without even knowing, you begin to talk about it. The thinking, listen carefully, the thinking and the talking about it is fertilizing it in your mind. The more you think about it, the more you talk about it, the more you fertilize that wrong information, that negative information. Your thinking and your talking is actually a fertilizing process. You are incubating. You can use several words. You are incubating. You are fertilizing what you have seen, what you have heard in your mind. And so this is important. And if you don't deal with it on time, it will become a stronghold. Just understand the process. You saw the picture. You heard the information. And now you allow it to stay. And the longer it stays, the more it will begin to germinate. It will grow. It will develop a reality in your mind. And eventually, it will become a stronghold. Something that becomes a hold on your life. It keeps you in bondage. You can't even get out of it again. Okay? And it becomes a stronghold that will manifest outwardly in your life. So many people are in bondage to imaginations of the mind that was left unchecked. They just allow it to stay. That is why you must be very, very, very careful of the informations you allow into your mind. The things you watch, the things you hear, they all contribute to the ingredients that your mind will begin to process and work upon. Now, a lecturer comes into class, just as an example. A lecturer comes to the class and says to the students, nobody will pass my course. I mean, for some of us who have gone to university, you understand what that means. Some lecturer can be so terrible. I mean, how can you come to class and say people will not pass after you have taught them? If you have taught them well, it will be your glory that they pass. But you find maybe certain, selfish needs from these individuals. They will tell their students, nobody will pass. And once the student begins to, once you receive that negative information and you begin to think about it, you begin to discuss among yourself, you are actually incubating, you are fertilizing that message that you have received in your mind. The next thing that most students will start to do is to think and to talk about it. And so when you have such experiences, we are supposed to deal with it. It can come in different ways. I'm not going to give all the examples, but it comes in various ways. You know, somebody said to you, if I don't help you, your life is finished. If I don't help you, that's the end of your life. And once you receive that kind of information, you can begin to dwell upon them. You incubate it, you fertilize, and become a strong God no matter what you do. Just realize that your life is not going for you. You make efforts, but it's like you are in circle because a word has become a strong God in your mind. And so, what do I do? Don't allow that word to stay. Don't allow it to germinate. And that means you must open your mouth and respond. You must respond in faith. Don't allow it to stay, or else You'll be trapped and enslaved by those negative information. Let the blood of Jesus cleanse your imagination. Avoid wrong movies, wrong music. Deal with that information. He said, casting down imaginations and bringing into captivity every thought. God will not do that for you. It's your assignment. It's your job. He said, no weapon that is formed against you shall prosper. He says, every tongue that will rise up against you in judgment, thou shalt condemn. Say, this is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and their righteousness is of me. And so you have a responsibility actually to condemn the information. Declare in your heart, I refuse that information. I decree that God's word alone will stand over my life. Plead the blood of Jesus over your conscience. Declare in the name of Jesus, I refuse to accept that negative information. It is not my portion. I will walk in the goodness of God alone in my life. Only God's counsel will stand over my life. Let's make a confession together. Say with me, my mind is set on what is pure. Hallelujah. My mind is set on what is godly. My mind is set on what is peaceful. My mind is set on what is beneficial. My mind is stayed on God. Now don't forget, it says it will keep in perfect peace them whose mind is stayed on God. Let your mind be stayed on God. Let your mind be stayed on this word. Let this word become your imagination also. Let this word become your thought pattern. Let God's word germinate, grow, and dominate your life. Bible said, this book of the law shall not depart out of your mouth. Thou shalt meditate upon it. Meditation is a process of imagination. Let it say, you shall meditate upon it day and night. Day and night. Let God's word saturate your mind and it will give direction to your life of success and the life of purpose. I'm so glad to have you here today. I'm so glad because I know your life is changing. God's purpose is standing over your life and you become all that God has ordained for you on the face of the earth. I want to ask you, let's work together. The earth shall be filled with the knowledge of the glory of God. Share this video with somebody on WhatsApp, on Facebook, on your status, share with somebody. And don't forget, if I'm not done, so subscribe to my YouTube channel. Encourage somebody else to do so also. Like the video, turn on your notifications, and you will see more videos every day. By the grace of God, every morning I'm sending daily prophecy to give direction to your life, and it will turn you to an amazement to your world. And I will see you in your destiny. God bless you, and I love you. Thank you.